Hello world and welcome back to EDU in 90. Today we'll be jumping back into the world of computer science and looking at some quick ways to get started with coding right on your Chromebooks.
Earlier this season, we looked at CS First, a Google coding curriculum that uses Scratch, an introductory language made of stackable blocks of code. On this episode, we'll give you the lowdown on web apps and share some of our favorite coding resources.
Web apps offer functionality that's similar to programs you'd install onto your device, but because they're cloud-based, they're always up to date. And as an added bonus, when you're signed into Chrome, you can access your favorite web apps from your Chromebook. Check the link in the description below for steps on how to set these up. There are lots of opportunities to use web apps in the classroom. Let's check out a few coding resources with great web apps.
When it comes to teaching younger students the fundamentals of coding, stackable instruction block tools are the best because they teach students basic coding concepts. For this type of coding, code.org is one of our favorite sites. Code.org has free coding curriculum, professional development resources for teachers, and coding environments for students to learn code through snapping blocks together. As your students build their coding skills, it's also a platform for text-based coding languages where they can build apps, games, and websites.
And let's talk about other coding environments, like ones for older students who are often learning text-based coding languages like Python, JavaScript, and HTML.
There are some great paid and free tools out there to help with this. You can get started with Trinket. It's a great web app since it doesn't require download plugins, installing software, or a subscription fee. It's designed for education and makes it easy to check and share modules called Trinkets.
Another popular one is Replit. It's built for classrooms, has tools exclusively for teachers, and in-browser coding environments for over 30 coding languages. It's also easy for students and teachers to share projects and has great teacher management systems as part of its paid feature set.
Lastly, VidCode helps students learn to code through augmented reality projects, Snapchat filters, memes, and more. It's developed a reputation for being easy for non-technical teachers to learn, and for using creative programs to ignite kids' interest in coding. Beyond coding environments, web apps can even be used for coding and controlling robots like Lego Mindstorms and Sphero, and for designing 3D printables through programs like BloxCAD.
And coding is just one use for web apps. They can also be used for recording voices, shooting video, organizing projects, or simplifying access to your top websites. Our time's up for today, but we'll have one more episode on coding this season, so keep an eye out for that. And in the meantime, tell us what you think in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe to the Google for Education YouTube channel. We'll see you next time.
Be sure to check out our last episode for more updates from Google for Education.